For me, that was the moment where I thought, this is what I want to work with.
I'm wondering if you could take us back to the day that you decided to use Kubernetes for your home lab.
That was when I was working in my first DevOps role, and we were using Ansible for everything. And they had built this super, actually very impressive system of deploying Docker servers and then having three Docker servers running the same container and then putting them there. But when one of those containers would die, then we would have to go in and fix it, right? Because you're limited by the tooling, even though there's probably ways of doing it with Ansible alone. That was my reality of the day, of the situation I was working in. And when I then, for the first time, created a Kubernetes cluster and I created a deployment with three replicas, and I killed one of those containers and then it came up automatically, I was sold. And then when I did a rolling update where I would update the image tag and then it would go one by one and then update the containers, and if something would go wrong, it would roll it back, that's when I felt totally in love with it, and I knew I could not go back. I for me, that was the moment where I thought, this is what I want to work with. When I then decided to do my home lab, to create a home lab, like, it wasn't even a thought. I never even considered anything else. It was just, yeah, I'm specializing in Kubernetes. Of course we need to run Kubernetes in my home lab. Even though it's completely overkill and it makes no sense, it had to be done on Kubernetes.
well, actually, I think it makes a lot of sense. And you talk about this in your video as well, why it makes sense and why it is important. And the majority would react that way. Like, what? It's overkill. Of course it's overkill. Yeah. Like, why not use Docker? You started with K3S. Why?
Part of me wanted to go the kubeadm way and just do it properly. Even kubeadm is a bit easier than doing it the hard way, like compiling the binaries yourself, etc. Still a goal that I have for maybe next year. I went for K3S because I recognized that the sooner I got up and running and actually working with the Kubernetes API and feeling that I had something stable to work with, the quicker I did that, the more I would learn, the quicker I would start learning. So I think it might felt like a shortcut at that time, but I thought long term, and I thought, well, with kubeadm, like, your own running your own CNI and having to update your certificates, like, it will work in the beginning, but if something breaks, then I'm just sitting there tinkering for hours. And I wanted something that was a little bit more thought through, and K3S was a very good option for that.
Why not kind?
I had a few Linux machines, and I really like this idea of that K3S does, where you install the binary and then you can get a token and then you can add another node to your cluster. And you can of course do this with kind as well, but I really like this idea of maintaining a Linux machine there where you install something on, but you still have the possibility of SSHing into it, and you still are a Linux administrator at that point, right? And I really like that balance, that I could have those Linux machines running Linux. I could tinker with it. I could still run other things on that machine as well, alongside K3S, and then just expand my home lab as I went along. I really like that concept.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so you mentioned SSH, which is interesting, because then you switch to Talos, and Talos prides itself on not having SSH.
Yes.
Why did you switch to Talos?
Well, I mean, that was that stage in my home lab. And then later I was running applications that I was thinking, well, this is actually running very stable. And my home lab has now escalated to a point where I don't want to live without it anymore. It's actually containing applications that I want to keep running 24/7, that I want to have accessible from the internet. And then the question of security comes around, and you need to, when you start exposing things to the internet, you need to really know what you're doing. It's a very dangerous situation if you don't know what you're doing and you're just opening ports and letting people into your cluster they could break out of your containers and do bad things. So I, at that point, I felt, okay, I want to have things more secure. And then Talos came on my radar, which is production-grade security out of the box. And it wasn't necessarily because I felt incapable of securing my own cluster. It was more a combination of learning a new technology and also having this peace of mind, knowing that what I was doing was actually secure. So then I switched to Talos, and yeah, I'm never going back. I think it's been amazing so far.